not there. Because that's what we must do for our future. This program is designed to make you aware of a few chapters of business and your life both. I have created the design of this session in such a way that it is applicable equally to those who are doing business and also to those who are not doing business, because both way the fundamentals are the same. It is talking about your story, and I think your business story is yet to be written. It is your story that we are talking about. And therefore, this session is applicable to you personally, individually, and try and receive as much as you can and ask yourself a question in your mind. Where am I when it comes to this particular aspect of doing business? Where do I stand when it comes to this particular aspect of life? Are you really, really into it? Are you creating your own identity? And that is a question. Now, it says there are no secrets of success. Absolutely no secrets of success. Let's not waste time looking for them. Success is a result of perfection, hard work, learning from failure, loyalty for those who you work, and your continuous persistence. Lage rahe hain aap. Jo kaam kar rahe hain, wo passion ke saath aap lage rahe hain. That is what brings success. And therefore, there are 9 keys to success in business that I am talking about. There are 9 keys of success in love affair that I am talking about. And each key of love affair is equally applicable to the business setup as well. Business is not a matter of chance. It is a matter of choice and hard work. It is not a thing to be waited for. It is a thing to be achieved. Let's not wait for the right things to happen. Let's not wait for the right products to come to us. Let's not wait for the customers to come to us. Let us create a strategy by which we go to the right products at the right time to the right customers, because customers don't come to us anymore. We must travel towards them and we must go and reach them, find them. They are meant for us. They are there somewhere in this world, but it's just that we are not able to reach them. And therefore, the strategy of current day business is to explore the various possibilities, multiple ways in which you can reach out to customers, be it a social media, be it your branding, be it your publicity, be it your blog, be it whatever it is, but we must reach out to far and wide corners of the world so that we become, you know, the successful businessman. We must have a vision. We must have the right attitude. We must take action. We must also be very ethical. Let us lead people and manage them. Let us manage our time. Let us update ourselves, and let us innovate. I think if these 9 keys are mastered by us, both in business and life, then probably we will be able to achieve the success, you know, that we desire. So let's go to key number 1. Aspiration is the vision. Develop your business vision. Let it be very powerful. Let it be something that inspires you. Let it be something that propels you, pushes you forward to do impossible things in life. Your business vision should not be linked to your current situation. It doesn't have anything to do with your current resources, the kind of capabilities that you have, the kind of resources you have. No, your vision is much beyond your current level of thinking. Your vision is much beyond your current level of limitations, because your vision is the future state of being. It's the future that you're living. It's the future that you're visualizing. And your future cannot be linked to your present, because if it is linked to your present, you will not be creating a future. You will be creating the present once again. The tomorrow is yet to come, and that tomorrow cannot be a shadow of today. And today cannot be a shadow of yesterday. So the past has nothing to do with today, because today you are there. The past are the learnings and the experiences. You can probably take them forward and make the sound judgments and decisions, but you can't simply follow the strategies that you did in the past. And therefore, we must have that powerful vision. When incidents were in the United States of America, John F. Kennedy, in the year 1960, he went to the Senate and said, I have a vision, the dream for this country, that this country in the next 10 years' time will be the first country in the world to go to the moon. That is the vision that he had. He says we need billions of dollars to support NASA so that this becomes a reality. He said, I want Senate to pass this finance. The Senate did not pass that finance. The Senate said, for the whims of the American president, we cannot spend such a lot of money. We will not do this. So John F. Kennedy said, please try and explore the possibility. Send some people to NASA. Find out for yourself if it is possible. If you think what I am talking about makes sense, then only you will pass this. Please don't ignore it right away. The committee was made. The senators went there. And one of the senators observed a small man working in a corner of the room. To initiate a conversation, this senator goes to him and says, hey man, what are you doing here? And that fellow actually was mopping the floor. वो फर्श को साफ कर रहा था वो सेनेटर की आंखों में आंखें डालता है हंस देता है बोलता है साहब मैं अमेरिका को सर्वप्रथम देश बना रहा हूं जो चांद पे इस दुनिया में सबसे पहले जाएगा द विजन ऑफ द अमेरिकन प्रेसिडेंट वेंट डाउन टू द क्लीनर ही वाज टॉकिंग इन द सेम लैंग्वेज दैट प्रोबेबली द अमेरिकन प्रेसिडेंट वाज टॉकिंग एंड देन They met all the scientists and engineers. A very positive report was given to the Senate. Senate passed that finance bill. And finally, it was in the year 1969 that Neil Armstrong went to the moon. The first country in the world. But you know what? John F. Kennedy in 1969 was not alive. कौन कहता है कि लीडर जो अपना काम करता है, वो फ्रूट्स के लिए करता है, वो तो एक इनिशिएट करता है. वो लोगों को तैयार करता है और जब फ्रूट्स मिलते हैं चाहे वो हो या ना हो मगर उसकी लेगेसी उसने जो काम किया है वो चलता रहता है एंड दिस इज व्हाट हैपेंड विद जॉन एफ कैनेडी इफ दिस हैपेंड विद जॉन एफ कैनेडी इट मस्ट आल्सो हैपन विद यू एंड मी वी मस्ट क्रिएट दैट विजन वी मस्ट बिलीव इन दैट विजन और जब वो चांद पे थे नील आर्मस्ट्रांग तब जब प्रेसिडेंट थे यूएस के उन्होंने पूछा कि पूरी जिंदगी में सालों से जब से पृथ्वी बनी है तब से हर इंसान ने चांद को यह धरती से देखा है हर इंसान ने चांद को इस धरती से देखा है पृथ्वी से देखा है तुम पहले इंसान हो जो आज चांद की धरती पे खड़े हो क्या वहां से पृथ्वी दिखती है क्या वहां से पृथ्वी दिखती है और दिखती है तो कैसी दिखती है तब नील आर्मस्ट्रांग जी कहते हैं कि हाँ मुझे पृथ्वी दिखती है एक बड़े गुब्बारे की तरह मुझे पृथ्वी दिखती है जिसमें से रंग बिरंगी किरणें उसमें से आ रही हो और बहुत कलरफुल गुब्बारा मुझे यहां से दिख रहा है ऐसी पृथ्वी मुझे यहां से दिखती है पृथ्वी को अगर बहुत बड़े गुब्बारे की तरह रंग से भरे हुए गुब्बारे की तरह देखना हो तो चांद की ऊंचाई तक जाना पड़ेगा तो चांद की ऊंचाई तक जाना पड़ेगा वहां तक की जब हमारी हमारी सोच होगी वहां तक की जब हमारी आस्थाएं हमारा विश्वास वहां इतना ऊंचा जाएगा तब जाके हम पृथ्वी को एक बड़ा गुब्बारा देख सकते हैं तब जाके आज 5-10-25-50 lakh का जो हमारा बिजनेस है उसे हम 5-10-25-50 crore के बिजनेस में उसको कन्वर्ट कर सकते हैं आई थिंक द एंटायर चेंज फर्स्ट स्टार्ट्स इन द माइंड If you conceive it, if you believe it, you will conceive it. If you conceive it, you will achieve it. But in order to achieve it, you must conceive it and thereafter believe in it. सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम ये होती है कि we are always worried about businesses. We don't have the exact shape and size written down, carved into the hearts and the soul of our being, so that we actually live with that vision, the power that the vision gives us. And I think that is the need. Of today, that we must believe in ourselves, and we must believe in the vision that we have. Have a look at this clipping.
Simply,